At the start of the movie, we're shown that two girls, Hunter and Becky, are stuck on a massive 2,000-meter-high tower. They try calling for help, but due to the high altitude, their phones have no reception. The worst thing is that the tower lies in the middle of a desert, so being spotted by someone is impossible. To make matters worse, some vultures have started attacking them. If they fall asleep, they will plunge directly to their deaths. The story then goes into a flashback, where Becky, her partner Dan, and her best friend Hunter are rock climbing. The three of them appear to be having a good time when Dan comes across a small hole. He puts his hand inside the hole to get a grip, but suddenly a bird emerges, causing him to fall and become entangled in the rope. Dan tries his best to swing to the rock, but to no avail. Becky and Hunter also try to help him, but the rope snaps and Dan falls to his death. The scene then shifts to 51 weeks later, and Becky is still haunted by the incident. She appears depressed and has been drinking excessively. Becky's father, James, is concerned about her and tries to persuade her to move on with her life, but she doesn't listen to him. One night, she considers taking her own life by consuming an excessive amount of medicine. As she's about to do it, she receives a phone call from Hunter after a long time. The next day, Hunter visits Becky and mentions her plan to climb the B67 TV tower. She also invites Becky to join her, mentioning that they can resurrect the adventure that they've been missing for a long time. Becky, who has been in pain, shows no interest in doing it. However, the next morning, when she reminisces about her time with Dan, she changes her mind and decides to climb it for him. Soon after, they both make their way to the tower. On their way, Becky notices some old photos of Hunter on her phone. As she scrolls through the photos, she notices one with a man's hand on Hunter. Becky inquires about the man, but Hunter doesn't reveal any information. Just then, Becky receives a phone call from her father, but she doesn't answer it. After a long drive, they stop at a motel to spend the night. While having their dinner, Becky learns that Hunter is now a vlogger and that she earns sufficient money to travel to new places. Meanwhile, they notice the TV tower, which appears to be the fourth tallest structure in the United States. The next morning, Becky and Hunter get into their car to continue their journey. Hunter begins driving and filming her vlogs, telling viewers about the 2,000-foot-tall tower. While concentrating on the vlog, they nearly collide with a truck. After a while, they arrive at the tower area, but the gate is closed with a danger sign. Regardless, they decide to abandon their car and begin walking through the deserted land. On their way, they notice vultures eating animal flesh, which Hunter documents in her vlog. She also uploads the animal's photo on social media, where it quickly gains numerous likes. A few moments later, they arrive at the tower, and Hunter resumes her vlogging. On the other hand, Becky becomes terrified of climbing as she's reminded of her past. She considers giving up, but Hunter persuades her to face her fears. Hunter then connects her rope to Becky's and begins climbing through the ladder inside the tower. The entire tower appears to be rusted, the ladder appears shaky, and the nut bolts are loose. While Becky is climbing, one of the metal rods of the ladder breaks, causing her to be terrified. Despite this, she gathers her courage and continues her ascent. Eventually, they reach the halfway point and notice that the city looks like a toy town. They take a brief break, drink some water, and then resume their ascent. After some time, they complete climbing 1,800 feet and now only have to climb the remaining 200 feet from the ladder outside the tower. Becky is terrified by the wind, height, and rusted condition of the tower. She requests Hunter to return back, but the ladder simply tells her to keep going. Following this, they begin climbing the outside ladder, which appears to be even more dangerous than the previous one. Soon after, they notice discs on their way and have to make their way from the side of the ladder. Hunter easily overcomes the obstacle and assists Becky in passing it. The wind grows stronger as they climb up, making Becky even more terrified. When Hunter notices this, she scares her even more by shaking the ladder. This causes the nut bolts to loosen and one of them falls out. Fortunately, it has no effect on the ladders and the two of them continue to climb. Before reaching the top, another nut bolt falls off the ladder. Finally, they reach the peak and begin taking photographs and videos. Still, Hunter is not content, so she grabs her drone to get better shots. Soon after, she hands over the control of the drone to Becky and hangs herself from the ledge in order to gain popularity. She then climbs back up and instructs Becky to do the same. When the latter hears this, she is taken aback and refuses to do it. However, Hunter persuades her, claiming that it's the only way for her to overcome her fear. Becky then takes Hunter's hand in hers and slowly hangs herself from the tower's ledge. At the same time, Hunter takes some selfies and pulls Becky up before the hands slip. After this, Becky blows away Dan's ashes and waves a final goodbye to him, creating an emotional moment for both of them. Now they decide to return, so they attach their harnesses and Becky goes first. But as soon as she climbs down, the ladder breaks, causing her to fall. Fortunately, Hunter grabs the rope and manages to pull Becky up. After the near-death experience, they both laugh like maniacs. However, their laughter quickly fades away when they notice that the ladders are no longer there. They check their phone, but it has no signal. They also notice that their bag, containing water and supplies, has fallen on the disc. In the tower, they discover binoculars and a flare gun, but they are useless. As a result, Becky panics, but Hunter calms her down by saying that the sound of the ladder falling must have been heard by someone. She also persuades Becky to wait until someone comes to their aid. As soon as the two are brainstorming ideas to escape the situation, Hunter notices a large cut on Becky's leg from the previous fall, so she immediately ties her shirt around the wound. After some time has passed, Becky begins interviewing Hunter, asking her why she began vlogging. Hunter responds that she started it because of Dan, creating a suspicion in Becky's mind. A few hours later, Hunter checks her phone and recalls posting the animal's picture earlier. She believes there's a signal at a certain height. She gets an idea, so she prepares a help post, ties her phone with the rope, and sends it as far down as she can, hoping that it will receive the signal and her post will be uploaded. However, their attempt fails. Despite this, they're confident that there's a signal at the base and decide to throw the phone down so that the help post can be uploaded. Hunter then puts her phone into her shoe and pads it up with her socks and push-up bra. After this, they throw the shoe and wait. Just then, Becky notices a 143 tattoo on Hunter's feet. It's revealed that Dan used the code 143 to express his love. A short time later, Hunter notices a man and a dog at the base of the tower. Seeing this, they scream for help, but their cries are not heard. We see that Hunter's phone has been destroyed, indicating that their plan has failed. As the man prepares to leave, Becky throws both of their shoes in an attempt to catch the man's attention, but in vain. She then decides to use the flare gun, but Hunter stops her because the man won't notice the flare during the day. Meanwhile, they also notice another man and discover that they have arrived for a party. They then intend to use the flare gun at night so that the men can easily notice it. Eventually, the night falls and Becky shoots the flare gun. Fortunately, the men notice the flare and also the girls waving for help. They quickly approach Hunter's car, making the girls overjoyed. However, instead of saving them, the men steal their car and drive away. This breaks the girls from inside, and now they have to find a new solution quickly. Later, Becky inquires about Hunter's tattoo, to which the latter reveals that she had an affair with Dan for 6 months. She then apologizes to Becky for falling in love with her guy and making a huge mistake. She claims she was drawn to Dan because, unlike other men, he used to listen to her. She loved him, but she loved Becky more, and as a result, she ended their affair. Hearing this, Becky is disappointed that her own friend and partner had betrayed her. The next morning, Becky's phone alarm goes off, indicating that it's been 24 hours since they threw Hunter's phone. Since they're extremely thirsty, Hunter decides to go down to the disc to get their bag. She ties one end of the rope to the tower and the other end to her own body. She then descends all the way down, but is still unable to reach the disc. Now, with no options left, Hunter opens her harness, hangs on the rope with one hand, and swings to the disc. She retrieves the bag and drinks some water from it. Then she uses her selfie stick, hooks the bag on the rope, and clings onto it. After this, Becky pulls the rope while Hunter climbs up. She's about to reach the top, but her hands slip and she falls. Becky's heartbeat stops, and when she looks down, she's relieved to see Hunter still holding on to the bag. However, Hunter's hand is injured, so Becky puts in all of her strength to pull her up. After a while, Becky writes a help note, attaches it to their drone, and decides to send it to the motel. Unfortunately, the drone is unable to travel far because its battery is running low, forcing them to bring it back. After failing one more time, they are helpless again. Later that night, Becky has a terrifying dream about vultures devouring Hunter's body. She immediately wakes up and realizes it was just a nightmare. The next morning, Becky realizes that they can charge the drone using the tower lights. She then climbs up the pole and plugs in the drone's charger, but it's too loose. As a result, she has to hold on to the charger until it's fully charged. Amidst the excruciating heat and constant attacks of the nearby vultures, she stands firm. But in the process, she drops the bag all the way down from the tower. After a while, the drone is fully charged and Becky climbs down. Soon after, Becky launches the drone towards the motel, but just as it's about to reach, a truck collides with it, destroying it completely. Seeing this, the girls are devastated because they see no other option. Later, a storm complicates their survival even more. Becky is exhausted and wants to sleep, but Hunter forbids her because the vultures might attack her. Becky then asks for Hunter's shoe to throw her phone down one more time. However, Hunter says that she's unable to do so because her shoe is on her feet, down on the disc. Here, it's revealed that Hunter couldn't hold on to the bag during the previous fall. Instead, she fell on the disc and died. Becky just pulled up the bag and has been surviving alone since then. Sadly, she's been hallucinating Hunter's presence all this time. At night, Becky manages to survive the storm. She also records a video message for her father in which she expresses her wish to return home. Elsewhere, James also appears to be concerned for her. The next day, the vulture notices Becky's defenselessness and begins eating her wounds. At the same time, Becky holds the vulture and strikes its head against the metal surface, killing it. She then eats the vulture's flesh in order to survive. Upon generating some energy in her body, she ties herself with the rope and jumps down on the disc where Hunter's body is lying. Following this, she sends a message to James and places her phone in Hunter's shoe. This time, she puts the shoe inside Hunter's body and throws it down. Later at night, James receives the message and immediately dials 911. He rushes to the scene and discovers the police transferring the dead body. Seeing this, he sobs, thinking the body belongs to Becky. But soon he's relieved to see his daughter alive. Finally, the father and daughter reunite, creating an emotional moment. That was all from the video. I hope you liked it. Subscribe for more content like this and hit the like button to help us out. Also, leave a comment if you want us to recap your favorite movie. Until next time, take care.